This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Federal Bureau of Investigation FBI is the domestic intelligence and security service of the United States, which simultaneously serves as the nation's prime federal law enforcement agency operating under the jurisdiction of the U.S. Department of Justice. The FBI is concurrently a member of the U.S. intelligence community and reports to both the Attorney General and the Director of National Intelligence, a leading U.S. counterterrorism, counterintelligence, and criminal investigative organization. The FBI has jurisdiction over violations of more than 200 categories of federal crimes. Although many of the FBI's functions are unique, its activities in support of national security are comparable to those of the British MI5 and the Russian FSB, unlike the Central Intelligence Agency CIA, which has no law enforcement authority and is focused on intelligence collection overseas. The FBI is primarily a domestic agency, maintaining 56 field offices in major cities throughout the United States, and more than 400 resident agencies in lesser cities and areas across the nation at an FBI field office. A senior-level FBI officer concurrently serves as the representative of the Director of National Intelligence despite its domestic focus. The FBI also maintains a significant international footprint, operating 60 legal attaché legate offices and 15 sub-offices in U.S. embassies and consulates across the globe. These overseas offices exist primarily for the purpose of coordination with foreign security services and do not usually conduct unilateral operations in the host countries. The FBI can and does at times carry out secret activities overseas. Just as the CIA has a limited domestic function, these activities generally require coordination across government agencies. The FBI was established in 1908 as the Bureau of Investigation BOI. Its name was changed to the Federal Bureau of Investigation FBI in 1935. The FBI headquarters is the J. Edgar Hoover Building, located in Washington, D.C. Contents 1. Budget, Mission and Priorities 2. History 21. Background 22. Creation 23. J. Edgar Hoover as Director 231. National Security 232. Japanese American Internment 233. Civil Rights Movement 234. Kennedy's Assassination 24. Organized Crime 25. Special FBI Teams 26. Notable efforts in the 1990s. The 27th of September 11 attacks 28. Faulty bullet analysis 3. Organization 31. Organizational structure 32. Rank structure 4. Legal authority 41. Indian reservations 5. Infrastructure 6. Personnel 61. Hiring process 62. BOI and FBI directors 7. Weapons 8. Publications 81. Crime statistics 811. Uniform crime reports 812. National incident-based reporting system 9. eGuardian 10. Controversies 101. Files on U.S. citizens 102. Covert operations on political groups 103. Files on Puerto Rican independence advocates 104. Activities in Latin America 105. Internal investigations of shootings 106. The Whitey Bulger case 107. Robert Hansen 108. Death of Filiberto Ojeda Rios 109. Wikipedia edits 10. Hillary Clinton email investigation 11. Media portrayal 12. Notable FBI personnel 13. See also 14. References 15. Further reading 16. External links. Budget, mission and priorities. In the fiscal year 2012, the Bureau's total budget was approximately $812 billion. The FBI's main goal is to protect and defend the United States, to uphold and enforce the criminal laws of the United States, and to provide leadership and criminal justice services to federal, state, municipal, and international agencies and partners. Currently, the FBI's top priorities are: protect the United States from terrorist attacks, protect the United States against foreign intelligence operations and espionage, protect the United States against cyber-based attacks and high-technology crimes, combat public corruption at all levels, protect civil rights, combat transnational, national criminal organizations and enterprises, combat major white-collar crime, combat significant violent crime, support federal, state, local and international partners, upgrade technology to successfully perform the FBI's mission. History. Background. In 1896, the National Bureau of Criminal Identification was founded, which provided agencies Across the country with information to identify known criminals. The 1901 assassination of President McKinley created an urgent perception that America was under threat from anarchists. The Department of Justice and the Department of Labor had been keeping records on anarchists for years, but President Theodore Roosevelt wanted more power to monitor them. The Justice Department had been tasked with regulating interstate commerce since 1887, though it lacked the staff to do so. It had made little effort to relieve its staff shortage until the Oregon land fraud scandal erupted around the start of the 20th century. President Roosevelt instructed Attorney General Charles Bonaparte to create an autonomous investigative service that would report only to the Attorney General. Bonaparte reached out to other agencies, including the Secret Service, for personnel, investigators in particular. On May 27, 1908, Congress forbade this use of Treasury employees by the Justice Department, citing fears that the new agency would serve as a secret police. Again at Roosevelt's urging, Bonaparte moved to organize a formal Bureau of Investigation with its own staff of special agents. Creation. The Bureau of Investigation Boy was created on July 26, 1908, after Congress had adjourned for the summer. Attorney General Bonaparte, using Department of Justice expense funds, hired 34 people, including some veterans of the Secret Service, to work for a new investigative agency. Its first chief, the title is now known as director, was Stanley Finch. Bonaparte notified Congress of these actions in December 1908. The Bureau's first official task was visiting and making surveys of the houses of prostitution in preparation for enforcing the White Slave Traffic Act, or Mann Act, passed on June 25, 1910. In 1932, the Bureau was renamed the United States Bureau of Investigation. The following year, it was linked to the Bureau of Prohibition and rechristened the Division of Investigation DOI before finally becoming an independent service within the Department of Justice in 1935. In the same year, its name was officially changed from the Division of Investigation to the present-day Federal Bureau of Investigation, or FBI. J. Edgar Hoover as Director. J. Edgar Hoover, Director from 1924 to 1972. J. Edgar Hoover served as Director from 1924 to 1972, a combined 48 years with the BOI, DOI, and FBI. He was chiefly responsible for creating the Scientific Crime Detection Laboratory, or the FBI Laboratory, which officially opened in 1932. As part of his work to professionalize investigations by the government, Hoover was substantially involved in most major cases and projects that the FBI handled during his tenure. After Hoover's death, Congress passed legislation that limited the tenure of future FBI directors to 10 years during the War on Crime of the 1930s. FBI agents apprehended or killed a number of notorious criminals who carried out kidnappings, robberies, and murders throughout the nation, including John Dillinger, Babyface Nelson, Kate Ma Barker, Alvin Creepy Carpus, and George Machine Gun Kelly. Other activities of its early decades included a decisive role in reducing the scope and influence of the Ku Klux Klan. Additionally, through the work of Edwin Atherton, the FBI claimed success in apprehending an entire army of Mexican neo-revolutionaries along the California border in the 1920s. Hoover began using wiretapping in the 1920s during Prohibition to arrest bootleggers. In the 1927 case Olmstead v. United States, in which a bootlegger was caught through telephone tapping, the United States Supreme Court ruled that FBI wiretaps did not violate the Fourth Amendment as unlawful search and seizure, as long as the FBI did not break into a person's home to complete the tapping. After Prohibition's repeal, Congress passed the Communications Act of 1934, which outlawed non-consensual phone tapping, but allowed bugging. In the 1939 case Nardone v. United States, the court ruled that due to the 1934 law, evidence the FBI obtained by phone tapping was inadmissible in court. After the 1967 case Katz v. United States overturned the 1927 case that had allowed bugging, Congress passed the Omnibus Crime Control Act, allowing public authorities to tap telephones during investigations as long as they obtain a warrant beforehand. National security. Beginning in the 1940s and continuing into the 1970s, the Bureau investigated cases of espionage against the United States and its allies. 8 Nazi agents who had planned sabotage operations against American targets were arrested, and 6 were executed ex parte curiam under their sentences. Also during this time, a joint U.S.-UK code-breaking effort, the Venona Project, with which the FBI was heavily involved, broke Soviet diplomatic and intelligence communications codes, allowing the U.S. US and British governments to read Soviet communications. This effort confirmed the existence of Americans working in the United States for Soviet intelligence. Hoover was administering this project but failed to notify the Central Intelligence Agency CIA until 1952. Another notable case is the arrest of Soviet spy Rudolf Abel in 1957. The discovery of Soviet spies operating in the US allowed Hoover to pursue his long-standing obsession with the threat he perceived from the American left, ranging from Communist Party of the United States of America CPUSA union organizers to American liberals. Japanese American internment in 1939, the Bureau began compiling a custodial detention list with the names of those who would be taken into custody in the event of war with Axis nations. The majority of the names on the list belonged to Issei community leaders, as the FBI investigation built on an existing naval intelligence index that had focused on Japanese Americans in Hawaii and the West Coast. But many German and Italian nationals also found their way onto the secret list. Robert Shivers, head of the Honolulu office, obtained permission from Hoover to start detaining those on the list on December 7, 1941. While bombs were still falling over Pearl Harbor, mass arrests and searches of homes, in most cases conducted without warrants, began a few hours after the attack, and over the next several weeks more than 5,500 Issei men were taken into FBI custody. On February 19, 1942, President Franklin Roosevelt issued Executive Order 9066, authorizing the removal of Japanese Americans from the West Coast. FBI Director Hoover opposed the subsequent mass removal and confinement of Japanese Americans authorized under Executive Order 9066, but Roosevelt prevailed. The vast majority went along with the subsequent exclusion orders, but in a handful of cases where Japanese Americans refused to obey the new military regulations, FBI agents handled their arrests. The Bureau continued surveillance on Japanese Americans throughout the war, conducting background checks on applicants for resettlement outside camp, and entering the camps usually without the permission of war relocation authority officials, and grooming informants in order to monitor dissidents and troublemakers. After the war, the FBI was assigned to protect returning Japanese Americans from attacks by hostile white communities. Civil rights movement. During the 1950s and 1960s, FBI officials became increasingly concerned about the influence of civil rights leaders, whom they believed had communist ties or were unduly influenced by them. In 1956, for example, Hoover sent an open letter denouncing Dr. T.R.M. Howard, a civil rights leader, surgeon, and wealthy entrepreneur in Mississippi who had criticized FBI inaction in solving recent murders of George W. Lee, Emmett Till, and other blacks in the South. The FBI carried out controversial domestic surveillance in an operation it called the COINTELPRO, a portmanteau derived from counterintelligence program. It was to investigate and disrupt the activities of dissident political organizations within the United States, including both militant and nonviolent organizations. Among its targets was the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, a leading civil rights organization with clergy leadership. The FBI frequently investigated Martin Luther King Jr. in the mid-1960s. King began publicly criticizing the Bureau for giving insufficient attention to the use of terrorism by white supremacists. Hoover responded by publicly calling King the most notorious liar in the United States in his 1991 memoir. Washington Post journalist Carl Rowan asserted that the FBI had sent at least one anonymous letter to King encouraging him to commit suicide. Historian Taylor Branch documents an anonymous November 1964 suicide package sent by the Bureau that combined a letter to the civil rights leader telling him, "You are done, there is only one way out for you," with audio recordings of King's sexual indiscretions. In March 1971, the residential office of an FBI agent in Media, Pennsylvania, was burglarized by a group calling itself the Citizens Commission to investigate the FBI. Numerous files were taken and distributed to a range of newspapers, including the Harvard Crimson. The files detailed the FBI's extensive COINTELPRO program, which included investigations into lives of ordinary citizens, including a black student group at a Pennsylvania military college and the daughter of Congressman Henry Roos of Wisconsin. The country was jolted by the revelations, which included assassinations of political activists, and the actions were denounced by members of Congress, including House Majority Leader Hale Boggs. The phones of some members of Congress, including Boggs, had allegedly been tapped. Kennedy's assassination. When President John F. Kennedy was shot and killed, the jurisdiction fell to the local police departments until President Lyndon B. Johnson directed the FBI to take over the investigation to ensure clarity about responsibility for investigation. investigation of homicides of federal officials, Congress passed a law that put investigations of deaths of federal officials within FBI jurisdiction. This new law was passed in 1965, Organized Crime in Response to Organized Crime. On August 25, 1953, the FBI created the Top Hoodlum Program. The National Office directed field offices to gather information on mobsters in their territories and to report it regularly to Washington for a centralized collection of intelligence on racketeers after the Racketeer-Influenced and Corrupt Organizations Act, or RICO Act, took effect. The FBI began investigating the former Prohibition organized groups, which had become fronts for crime in major cities and small towns. All of the FBI work was done undercover and from within these organizations, using the provisions provided in the RICO Act. Gradually, the agency dismantled many of the groups, although Hoover initially denied the existence of a national crime syndicate in the United States. The Bureau later conducted operations against known organized crime syndicates and families, including those headed by Sam Giancana and John Gotti. The RICO Act is still used today for all organized crime and any individuals who might fall under the act. In 2003, a congressional committee called the FBI's Organized Crime Informant Program one of the greatest failures in the history of federal law enforcement. The FBI allowed four innocent men to be convicted of the March 1965 gangland murder of Edward Teddy Deegan in order to protect Vincent Flemmi, an FBI informant. Three of the men were sentenced to death, which was later reduced to life in prison, and the fourth defendant was sentenced to life in prison. Two of the four men died in prison after serving almost 30 years, and two others were released after serving 32 and 36 years. In July 2007, U.S. District Judge Nancy Gertner in Boston found the Bureau helped convict the four men using false witness account by mobster Joseph Barboza. The U.S. government was ordered to pay $100 million in damages to the four defendants' special FBI teams, FBI SWAT agents, in a training exercise in 1982. The FBI formed an elite unit to help with problems that might arise at the 1984 Summer Olympics to be held in Los Angeles, particularly terrorism and major crime. This was a result of the 1972 Summer Olympics at Munich, Germany, when terrorists murdered the Israeli athletes named Hostage Rescue Team HRT. It acts as the FBI lead for a national SWAT team in related procedures and all counterterrorism cases. Also formed in 1984 was the Computer Analysis and Response Team CART. From the end of the 1980s to the early 1990s, the FBI reassigned more than 300 agents from foreign counterintelligence duties to violent crime, and made violent crime the sixth national priority with reduced cuts to other well-established departments. And because terrorism was no longer considered a threat after the end of the Cold War, the FBI assisted local and state police forces in tracking fugitives who had crossed state lines, which is a federal offense. The FBI laboratory helped develop DNA testing, continuing its pioneering role in identification that began with its fingerprinting system in 1924. Notable efforts in the 1990s. An FBI agent tags the cockpit voice recorder from Egyptair Flight 990 on the deck of the USS Grapple 53 Argentine pesos at the crash site on November 13, 1999. Between 1993 and 1996, the FBI increased its counterterrorism role in the wake of the first 1993 World Trade Center bombing in New York City, New York, the 1995 Oklahoma City bombing in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, and the arrest of the Unabomber in 1996. Technological innovation and the skills of FBI laboratory analysts helped ensure that the three cases were successfully prosecuted. Justice Department investigations into the FBI's roles in the Ruby Ridge and Waco incidents were found to be obstructed by agents within the Bureau during the 1996 Summer Olympics in Atlanta, Georgia. The FBI was criticized for its investigation of the Centennial Olympic Park bombing. It has settled a dispute with Richard Jewell, who was a private security guard at the venue, along with some media organizations, in regard to the leaking of his name during the investigation after Congress passed the Communications Assistance for Law Enforcement Act CALEA, 1994, the Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act HIPAA, 1996, and the Economic Espionage Act EEA, 1996. The FBI followed suit and underwent a technological upgrade in 1998, just as it did with its CART team in 1991. Computer Investigations and Infrastructure Threat Assessment Center CITAC and the National Infrastructure Protection Center NIPC were created to deal with the increase in internet-related problems, such as computer viruses, worms, and other malicious Programs that threatened U.S. operations with these developments, the FBI increased its electronic surveillance in public safety and national security investigations, adapting to the telecommunications advancements that changed the nature of such problems. September 11 attacks. During the September 11, 2001, attacks on the World Trade Center, FBI agent Leonard W. Hatton Jr. was killed during the rescue effort while helping the rescue personnel evacuate the occupants of the South Tower and stayed when it collapsed within months. After the attacks, FBI Director Robert Mueller, who had been sworn in a week before the attacks, called for a re-engineering of FBI structure and operations. He made countering every federal crime a top priority, including the prevention of terrorism, countering foreign intelligence operations, addressing cybersecurity threats, other high-tech crimes, protecting civil rights, combating public corruption, organized crime, white-collar crime, and major acts of violent crime. In February 2001, Robert Hansen was caught selling information to the Russian government. It was later learned that Hansen, who had reached a high position within the FBI, had been selling intelligence since as early as 1979. He pleaded guilty to treason and received a life sentence in 2002, but the incident led many to question the security practices employed by the FBI. There was also a claim that Robert Hansen might have contributed information that led to the September 11, 2001, attacks. The 9/11 Commission's final report on July 22, 2004, stated that the FBI and Central Intelligence Agency CIA were both partially to blame for not pursuing intelligence reports that could have prevented the September 11, 2001, attacks. In its most damning assessment, the report concluded that the country had not been well served by either agency and listed numerous recommendations for changes within the FBI. While the FBI has acceded to most of the recommendations, including oversight by the new Director of National Intelligence, some former members of the 9/11 Commission publicly criticized the FBI in October 2005, claiming it was resisting any meaningful changes. On July 8, 2007, The Washington Post published excerpts from UCLA professor Amy Zegart's book Spying Blind: The CIA, the FBI, and the Origins of 9/11. The Post reported from Zegart's book that government documents show the CIA and FBI missed 23 potential chances to disrupt the terrorist attacks of September 11, 2001. The primary reasons for the failures included agency cultures resistant to change and new ideas, inappropriate incentives for promotion, and a lack of cooperation between the FBI, CIA, and the rest of the United States intelligence community. The book blamed the FBI's decentralized structure, which prevented effective communication and cooperation among different FBI offices. The book suggested that the FBI has not evolved into an effective counterterrorism or counterintelligence agency, due in large part to deeply ingrained agency cultural resistance to change. For example, FBI personnel practices continue to treat all staff other than special agents as support staff, classifying intelligence analysts alongside the FBI's auto mechanics and janitors. Faulty bullet analysis. For over 40 years, the FBI crime lab in Quantico believed lead-in bullets had unique chemical signatures. It analyzed the bullets with the goal of matching them chemically, not only to a single batch of ammunition coming out of a factory, but also to a single box of bullets. The National Academy of Sciences conducted an 18-month independent review of comparative bullet lead analysis in 2003. Its National Research Council published a report whose conclusions called into question 30 years of FBI testimony. It found the analytic model used by the FBI for interpreting results was deeply flawed, and the conclusion, that bullet fragments could be matched to a box of ammunition, was so overstated that it was misleading under the rules of evidence. 1 year later, the FBI decided to stop doing bullet lead analysis after a 60 Minutes, Washington Post investigation in November 2007. 2 years later, the Bureau agreed to identify, review, and release all pertinent cases, and notify prosecutors about cases in which faulty testimony was given. Organizational structure. Organization chart for the FBI as of July 15, 2014. The FBI is organized into functional branches and the Office of the Director, which contains most administrative offices. An Executive Assistant Director manages each branch. Each branch is then divided into offices and divisions, each headed by an Assistant Director. The various divisions are further divided into sub-branches, led by Deputy Assistant Directors. Within these sub-branches, there are various sections headed by Section Chiefs. Section Chiefs are ranked analogous to Special Agents in Charge. 4 of the branches report to the Deputy Director, while two report to the associate director. The functions branches of the FBI are, FBI Intelligence Branch, FBI National Security Branch, FBI Criminal, Cyber, Response, and Services Branch, FBI Science and Technology Branch, FBI Information and Technology Branch, FBI Human Resources Branch. The Office of the Director serves as the central administrative organ of the FBI. The office provides staff support functions such as finance and facilities management to the five function branches and the various field divisions. The office is managed by the FBI Associate Director, who also oversees the operations of both the Information and Technology and Human Resources Branches. Office of the Director, Immediate Office of the Director, Office of the Deputy Director, Office of the Associate Director, Office of Congressional Affairs, Office of Equal Employment Opportunity Affairs, Office of the General Counsel, Office of Integrity and Compliance, Office of the Ombudsman, Office of Professional Responsibility, Office of Public Affairs Inspection Division, Facilities and Logistics Services Division, Finance Division, Records Management Division, Resource Planning Office, Security Division. Rank structure. The following is a complete listing of the rank structure found within the FBI: Field Agents, Probationary Agent, Special Agent, Senior Special Agent, Supervisory Special Agent, Assistant Special Agent in Charge, ASAC Special Agent in Charge, SAC, FBI Management, Deputy Assistant Director, Assistant Director, Associate Executive Assistant Director, Executive Assistant Director, Associate Deputy Director, Deputy Chief of Staff, Chief of Staff and Special Counsel to the Director, Deputy Director. Director, Legal Authority, FBI Badge and Service Pistol, a Glock Model 22, 40S. Of those who are suspected of terrorism, something it had supposedly not done since the 1970s, in the early 1980s, Senate hearings were held to examine FBI undercover operations in the wake of the Abscam controversy, which had allegations of entrapment of elected officials as a result. In following years, a number of guidelines were issued to constrain FBI activities. A March 2007 report by the Inspector General of the Justice Department described the FBI's widespread and serious misuse of national security letters, a form of administrative subpoena used to demand records and data pertaining to individuals. The report said that between 2003 and 2005, the FBI had issued more than 140,000 national security letters, many involving people with no obvious connections to terrorism. Information obtained through an FBI investigation is presented to the appropriate U.S. Attorney or Department of Justice official, who decides if prosecution or other action is warranted. The FBI often works in conjunction with other federal agencies, including the U.S. Coast Guard USCG and U.S. Customs and Border Protection CBP in seaport and airport security, and the National Transportation Safety Board in investigating airplane crashes and other critical incidents. Immigration and Customs Enforcement, Homeland Security Investigations. ICE has nearly the same amount of investigative manpower as the FBI, and investigates the largest range of crimes in the wake of the September 11 attacks. Then Attorney General Ashcroft assigned the FBI as the designated lead organization in terrorism investigations after the creation of the U.S. Department of Homeland Security. ICE and the FBI are both integral members of the Joint Terrorism Task Force. Indian reservations. The federal government has the primary responsibility for investigating and prosecuting serious crime on Indian reservations. There are 565 federally recognized American Indian tribes in the United States, and the FBI has federal law enforcement responsibility on nearly 200 Indian reservations. This federal jurisdiction is shared concurrently with the Bureau of Indian Affairs, Office of Justice Services BIA OJS, located within the FBI's Criminal Investigative Division. The Indian Country Crimes Unit ICCU is responsible for developing and implementing strategies, programs, and policies to address identified crime problems in Indian Country. IC, for which the FBI has responsibility. Overview. Indian Country Crime. The FBI does not specifically list crimes in Native American land as one of its priorities. Often serious crimes have been either poorly investigated or prosecution has been declined. Tribal courts can impose sentences of up to 3 years, under certain Restrictions Infrastructure J. Edgar Hoover Building, FBI Headquarters FBI Mobile Command Center, Washington Field Office The FBI is headquartered at the J. Edgar Hoover Building in Washington, D.C., with 56 field offices in major cities across the United States. The FBI also maintains over 400 resident agencies across the United States, as well as over 50 legal attachés at United States embassies and consulates. Many specialized FBI functions are located at facilities in Quantico, Virginia, as well as a data campus in Clarksburg, West Virginia, where 96 million sets of fingerprints from across the United States are stored, along with others collected by American authorities from prisoners in Saudi Arabia and Yemen, Iraq, and Afghanistan. The FBI is in process of moving its Records Management Division, which processes Freedom of Information Act FOIA requests, to Winchester, Virginia. According to the Washington Post, the FBI is building a vast repository controlled by people who work in a top-secret vault on the fourth floor of the J. Edgar Hoover Building in Washington. This one stores the profiles of tens of thousands of Americans and legal residents who are not accused of any crime. What they have done is appear to be acting suspiciously to a town sheriff, a traffic cop, or even a neighbor. The FBI laboratory, established with the formation of the BOI, did not appear in the J. Edgar Hoover Building until its completion in 1974. The lab serves as the primary lab for most DNA, biological, and physical work. Public tours of FBI headquarters ran through the FBI laboratory workspace before the move to the J. Edgar Hoover Building. The services the lab conducts include chemistry, combined DNA index system CODIS, computer analysis and response, DNA analysis, evidence response, explosives, firearms and tool marks, forensic audio, forensic video, image analysis, forensic science research, forensic science training, hazardous materials response, investigative and prospective graphics, latent prints, materials analysis, questioned documents, racketeering records, special photographic analysis, structural design, and trace evidence. The services of the FBI laboratory are used by many state, local, and international agencies free of charge. The lab also maintains a second lab at the FBI Academy. The FBI Academy, located in Quantico, Virginia, is home to the Communications and Computer Laboratory the FBI utilizes. It is also where new agents are sent for training to become FBI special agents. Going through the 21-week course is required for every special agent. First opened for use in 1972, the facility located on 385 acres 16. Firearms Training Unit, Forensic Science Research and Training Center, Technology Services Unit SU, Investigative Training Unit, Law Enforcement Communication Unit, Leadership and Management Science Units LSMU, Physical Training Unit, New Agents Training Unit NATU, Practical Applications Unit POW, the Investigative Computer Training Unit and the College of Analytical Studies. In 2000, the FBI began the Trilogy project to upgrade its outdated information technology IT infrastructure. This project, originally scheduled to take 3 years and cost around $380 million, ended up going far over budget and behind schedule. Efforts to deploy modern computers and networking equipment were generally successful, but attempts to develop new investigation software, outsourced to Science Applications International Corporation SAIC, were not virtual case file, or VCF, as the software was known, was plagued by poorly defined goals and repeated changes in management. In January 2005, more than 2 years after the software was originally planned for completion, the FBI officially abandoned the project. At least $100 million and much more by some estimates was spent on the project, which never became operational. The FBI has been forced to continue using its decade-old automated case support system, which IT experts consider woefully inadequate. In March 2005, the FBI announced it was beginning a new, more ambitious software project, code-named Sentinel, which they expected to complete by 2009. Carnivore was an electronic eavesdropping software system implemented by the FBI during the Clinton administration. It was designed to monitor email and electronic communications after prolonged negative coverage in the press. The FBI changed the name of its system from Carnivore to DCS-1000. DCS is reported to stand for Digital Collection System. The system has the same functions as before. The Associated Press reported in mid-January 2005 that the FBI essentially abandoned the use of Carnivore in 2001, in favor of commercially available software, such as NARASinsight. The Criminal Justice Information Services CJIS Division, is located in Clarksburg, West Virginia. Organized beginning in 1991, the office opened in 1995 as the youngest agency division. The complex has the length of 3 football fields. It provides a main repository for information in various data systems. Under the roof of the CJIS are the programs for the National Crime Information Center NCIC, Uniform Crime Reporting UCR, Fingerprint Identification, Integrated Automated Fingerprint Identification System IAFIS, NCIC 2000, and the National Incident-Based Reporting System NIBRS. Many state and local agencies use these data systems as a source for their own investigations and contribute to the database using secure communications. FBI provides these tools of sophisticated identification and information services to local, state, federal, and international law enforcement agencies. FBI is in charge of National Virtual Translation Center, which provides timely and accurate translations of foreign intelligence for all elements of the intelligence community. Personnel and FBI evidence response team agents in training on the FBI Academy firing range. As of December 31, 2009, the FBI had a total of 33,852 employees. That includes 13,412 special agents and 20,420 support professionals, such as intelligence analysts, language specialists, scientists, information technology specialists, and other professionals. The Officer Down Memorial page provides the biographies of 58 FBI agents killed in the line of duty from 1925 to 2011. Hiring process. The FBI is near impenetrable, with applicants intensely scrutinized and assessed over an extended period. To apply to become an FBI agent, one must be between the ages of 23 and 37. Due to the decision in Robert P. Isabella v. Department of State and Office of Personnel Management, 2008 MSP B-146, preference-eligible veterans may apply after age 37. In 2009, the Office of Personnel Management issued implementation guidance on the Isabella decision. The applicant must also hold American citizenship, be of high moral character, have a clean record, and hold at least a 4-year bachelor's degree. At least 3 years of professional work experience prior to application is also required. All FBI employees require a top-secret TS security clearance, and in many instances, employees need a TS/SI top secret, sensitive compartmented information clearance to obtain a security clearance. All potential FBI personnel must pass a series of single scope background investigations SSBI, which are conducted by the Office of Personnel Management. Special agents candidates also have to pass a physical fitness test PFT, which includes a 300 meter run, 1 minute sit ups, maximum push ups, and a 15 mile 24. Only to his successors. The current FBI director is James B. Comey, who was appointed in 2013 by Barack Obama. The FBI director is responsible for the day-to-day operations at the FBI along with his deputies. The director makes sure cases and operations are handled correctly. The director also is in charge of making sure the leadership in any one of the FBI field offices is manned with qualified agents. Before the Intelligence Reform and Terrorism Prevention Act was passed in the wake of the September 11th attacks, the FBI director would directly brief the President of the United States on any issues that arise from within the FBI. Since then, the director now reports to the Director of National Intelligence DNI, who in turn reports to the President. Weapons: a Glock 22 pistol in 40s. Secondary weapons. Special agents are authorized to purchase and qualify with the Glock Model 21 in 45 ACP. Special agents of the FBI HRT Hostage Rescue Team and Regional SWAT teams are issued the Springfield Professional Model 1911A145 ACP pistol. See FBI Special Weapons and Tactics Teams publications. The FBI Law Enforcement Bulletin is published monthly by the FBI Law Enforcement Communication Unit, with articles of interest to state and local law enforcement personnel first published in 1932 as fugitives wanted by police. The FBI Law Bulletin covers topics including law enforcement technology and issues, such as crime mapping and use of force, as well as recent criminal justice research, and VCAP alerts, on wanted suspects and key cases. The FBI also publishes some reports for both law enforcement personnel as well as regular citizens covering topics including law enforcement, terrorism, cybercrime, white-collar crime, violent crime, and statistics. However, the vast majority of federal government publications covering these topics are published by the Office of Justice Programs agencies of the United States Department of Justice, and disseminated through the National Criminal Justice Reference Service crime statistics. In the 1920s, the FBI began issuing crime reports by gathering numbers from local police departments due to limitations of this system found during the 1960s and 1970s. Victims often simply did not report crimes to the police in the first place. The Department of Justice developed an alternate method of tallying crime, the Victimization Survey Uniform Crime Reports main article, Uniform Crime Reports. The Uniform Crime Reports UCR compiled data from over 17,000 law enforcement agencies across the country. They provide detailed data regarding the volume of crimes to include arrest, clearance or closing a case, and law enforcement officer information. The UCR focuses its data collection on violent crimes, hate crimes, and property crimes created in the 1920s. The UCR system has not proven to be as uniform as its name implies. The UCR data only reflect the most serious offense in the case of connected crimes and has a very restrictive definition of rape, since about 93% of the data submitted to the FBI is in this format. The UCR stands out as the publication of choice, as most states require law enforcement agencies to submit this data. Preliminary annual Uniform Crime Report for 2006 was released on June 4, 2006. The report shows violent crime offenses rose 13%, but the number of property crime offenses decreased 29% compared to 2005. National Incident-Based Reporting System main article, National Incident-Based Reporting System. The National Incident-Based Reporting System NIBRS crime statistics system aims to address limitations inherent in UCR data. The system is used by law enforcement agencies in the United States for collecting and reporting data on crimes. Local, state, and federal agencies generate NIBRS data from their records management systems. Data is collected on every incident and arrest in the Group A offense category. The Group A offenses are 46 specific crimes grouped in 22 offense categories. Specific facts about these offenses are gathered and reported in the NIBRS system. In addition to the Group A offenses, 11 Group B offenses are reported with only the arrest information. The NIBRS system is in greater detail than the summary-based UCR system. As of 2004, 5,271 law enforcement agencies submitted NIBRS data. That amount represents 20% of the United States population and 16% of the crime statistics data collected by the FBI. eGuardian. eGuardian is the name of an FBI system, launched in January 2009, to share tips about possible terror threats with local police agencies. The program aims to get law enforcement at all levels sharing data quickly about suspicious activity and people. eGuardian enables near real-time sharing and tracking of terror information and suspicious activities with local, state, tribal, and federal agencies. The eGuardian system is a spin-off of a similar but classified tool called Guardian that has been used inside the FBI and shared with vetted partners since 2005. Controversies throughout its history, the Bureau has been the subject of a number of controversial cases, both at home and abroad. Files on U.S. citizens. The FBI has maintained files on numerous people, including celebrities such as Elvis Presley, Frank Sinatra, John Denver, John Lennon, Jane Fonda, Groucho Marx, Charlie Chaplin, the band MC5, Lou Costello, Sonny Bono, Bob Dylan, Michael Jackson, and Mickey Mantle. The files were collected for various reasons. Some of the subjects were investigated for alleged ties to the Communist Party, Charlie Chaplin and Groucho Marx, or in connection with anti-war activities during the Vietnam War. John Denver, John Lennon, and Jane Fonda. Numerous celebrity files concerned threats or extortion attempts against them. Sonny Bono, John Denver, John Lennon, Elvis Presley, Michael Jackson, Mickey Mantle, Groucho Marx, and Frank Sinatra. Covert operations on political groups. COINTELPRO tactics have been alleged to include discrediting targets through psychological warfare, smearing individuals and groups using forged documents and by planting false reports in the media, harassment, wrongful imprisonment, and illegal violence. The FBI stated Motivation was protecting national security, preventing violence, and maintaining the existing social and political order. FBI records showed that 85% of COINTELPRO resources targeted groups and individuals that the FBI deemed subversive, including communist and socialist organizations, organizations and individuals associated with the civil rights movement, including Martin Luther King Jr. and others associated with the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, and the Congress of Racial Equality and other civil rights organizations, black nationalist groups, the American Indian Movement, a broad range of organizations labeled New Left, including Students for a Democratic Society and the Weathermen, almost all groups protesting the Vietnam War, as well as individual student demonstrators with no group affiliation, the National Lawyers Guild, organizations and individuals associated with the women's rights movement, nationalist groups such as those seeking independence for Puerto Rico, United Ireland, and Cuban exile movements including Orlando Bosch's Cuban Power and the Cuban Nationalist Movement. The remaining 15% of COINTELPRO resources were expended to marginalize and subvert white hate groups, including the Ku Klux Klan and the National States Rights Party. Files on Puerto Rican independence advocates. The FBI also spied upon and collected information on Puerto Rican independence leader Pedro Albizu Campos and his nationalist political party in the 1930s. Albizu Campos was convicted three times in connection with deadly attacks on U.S. government officials, in 1937 conspiracy to overthrow the government of the United States, in 1950 attempted murder, and in 1954 after an armed assault on the U.S. House of Representatives while in session. Although not present, Albizu Campos was considered the mastermind. The FBI operation was covert and did not become known until U.S. Congressman Luis Gutierrez had it made public via the Freedom of Information Act in the 1980s. In the 2000s, researchers got files released by the FBI under the Freedom of Information Act revealing that the San Juan FBI office had coordinated with FBI offices in New York, Chicago, and other cities, in a decades-long surveillance of Albizu Campos and Puerto Ricans who had contact or communication with him. The documents available are as recent as 1965 activities in Latin America from the 1950s to the 1980s, the governments of many Latin American and Caribbean countries were infiltrated by the FBI. Internal investigations of shootings during the period from 1993 to 2011, FBI agents fired their weapons on 289 occasions. FBI internal reviews found the shots justified in all but five cases. In none of the five cases were people wounded. Samuel Walker, a professor of criminal justice at the University of Nebraska, Omaha, said the number of shots found to be unjustified was suspiciously low. In the same time period, the FBI wounded 150 people, 70 of whom died. The FBI found all 150 shootings to be justified. Likewise, during the period from 2011 to the present, all shootings by FBI agents have been found to be justified by internal investigation. In a 2002 case in Maryland, an innocent man was shot, and later paid $13 million by the FBI after agents mistook him for a bank robber. The internal investigation found that the shooting was justified, based on the man's actions. The Whitey Bulger case. The FBI has been criticized for its handling of Boston organized crime figure Whitey Bulger. Beginning in 1975, Bulger served as an informant for the FBI. As a result, the Bureau largely ignored his organization in exchange for information about the inner workings of the Italian-American Patriarca crime family. In December 1994, after being tipped off by his former FBI handler about a pending indictment under the Racketeer-Influenced and Corrupt Organizations Act, Bulger fled Boston and went into hiding for 16 years. He remained at large for 12 of those years. Bulger was prominently listed on the FBI 10 Most Wanted Fugitives list beginning in 1997. The New England media exposed criminal actions by federal, state, and local law enforcement officials tied to Bulger. The revelation caused great embarrassment to the FBI in 2002. Special Agent John J. Connolly was convicted of federal racketeering charges for helping Bulger avoid arrest in 2008. Special Agent Connolly completed his term on the federal charges and was transferred to Florida, where he was convicted of helping plan the murder of John B. Callahan, a Bulger rival, in 2014. That conviction was overturned on a technicality. Connolly was the agent leading the investigation of Bulger in June 2011. The 81-year-old Bulger was arrested in Santa Monica, California. Bulger was tried on 32 counts of racketeering, money laundering, extortion, and weapons charges, including complicity in 19 murders in August 2013. The jury found him guilty on 31 counts, and having been involved in 11 murders, Bulger was sentenced to 2 consecutive life terms plus 5 years. Robert Hansen on the 20th of February 2001, the Bureau announced that a special agent, Robert Hansen, born 1944, had been arrested for spying for the Soviet Union and then Russia from 1979 to 2001. He is serving 15 consecutive life sentences without the possibility of parole at ADX Florence, a federal supermax prison near Florence, Colorado. Hansen was arrested on February 18, 2001, at Foxstone Park near his home in Vienna, Virginia, and was charged with selling U.S. secrets to the USSR and subsequently Russia for more than $14 million in cash and diamonds over a 22-year period on July